I like that last one.
Gregory Carlyle, can you tell me where you were yesterday evening?
Oh, you're wondering about my alibi, Mr. Detective. Well, I left Thornbridge around 8:30 for a pint with Edward. I wish I hadn't. Quiz night at the inn. On the other hand, staying here with Zachary, my obnoxious sister, and the wife sporting another one of her headaches would have been a fate worse than death. the short of it, Zachary was very much alive when we left. I stayed for the last shout, and I was back here just before midnight. Is that
Tell me about Zachary.
Zach? Such a sad old sod. A bit heavy on the bottle. But who could blame him? Only company he had was his rare plants and mother, who travels more than she stays here. Honestly, I can't say which is the bigger bore. He's better off dead. Anything else you want to pry from my intricate intellect?
Anything else you'd like to tell me?
Nothing, really. I'm just enjoying the show. Our perfect mother obviously fucked up, didn't she? Faking her own death. You know, she's explained nothing to us. I think she's scared to own up to her own mistake.
That is the door to Mr. Fernsby's office.
Painkiller. Lethal, if you use enough of them.
But not the poison used to kill Zachary. Of course, Madame Carlyle doesn't know that. Are you considering to frame the butler, 47? Mr. Fernsby clearly didn't commit the murder, but I think you have enough evidence to convince Madame Carlyle he did. Maybe you should tell him you are ready to present your findings. Unless, of course, you want to do some more detecting, 47?
Thank you.
Hello there, sir.
Of high
actually,
Mr. Fernsby, my...
Yeah, I
should right,
let you
later.
Go.
Rebecca, do you see this about old Wompy? He used to fancy her, didn't he? Maybe you can get an exclusive for one of your papers.
I thought. I don't think my readers care much about this.
I'm sorry.
Sir, you should go back the way. Yeah, and stay out.
Portrait photographer check out. You verified his identity.
I vetted him thoroughly. He's good.
Even guests will attend the funeral.
It's already done.
There's still a lot to see to, but we're in good time, I think.
I can't deal with all this pretend funeral stuff just now.
Rosie, tell me what you did last night.
I'm in trouble, aren't I? I spent the evening with Patrick. We met after dinner,
I trust
and
you'll
I went
have
home
all the
at
trimming
one
done
in the morning.
By
all will be neat
he
and
said
tidy.
He needed someone real to talk to. When he looks at you, it makes you feel like the center of
make
the
sure
universe.
Make sure the gardening tools are put
like
away before tomorrow.
But now
I'll make
he just
sure
ignores
everything
her.
Is ready.
Well, he's under a lot of pressure.
He's an idiot. That's what he is.
Did you notice anything out of the ordinary? Any strangers outside the house?
No, we saw no one outside. Except Patrick's mother, Emma. We were sitting on the bench behind the greenhouse talking when she came out and, we had to hide. You won't tell her about me and Patrick, will you? She'd insist Madame Carlyle fire me. I'm sure of it.
Too right she will. She's always going on about how things will change once she's in charge of Thornbridge Manor.
Fake funeral tomorrow. Zachary found dead upstairs today. Death is everywhere. I never thought of it that way. Oh, God.
Would you mind
it's such
taking
a big responsibility
a few steps away
having a baby.
Me, please?
I have to protect it, right? How'd you even do that? I can't do that.
You'll be fine, Robbie. Kids are great.
I shouldn't gossip. But that Emma woman is a tad too busy for my taste.
What is it now?
She turned up and demanded to be put up in Madame Carlyle's bedroom. We're the new heads of the family after all. It is only fitting, she said. Well, Gregory, stop.
Hi.
Don Yates, Alexa Carlyle here. You need to explain yourself.
I demand that you return my call ASAP. Sending a junior attorney.
Looking good today, sir.
What the? Sorry, but I think I...
Right. Yeah.
My parents would hate him.
How are you today, sir? Gates.
Maybe we should get back to...
Yeah. Stay away from me, sir. You could get hurt.
Bloody foam,
you coward! How dare you interfere with my life like this? You're a nobody, a weasel, overreaching your competences. You are in way over your head, and I will make you pay. You can count on that.
Did you want to check on that undertaker in charge of the funeral? I got word he's upset with Madame Carlyle.
I did, sir. It all checked out.
Anything to report?
Nothing new, madam.
That American lawyer in the small office, did you check his travel documents?
Everything's in order.
Of interesting stories.
Could I actually
put a pin in it.
Yeah, yeah. I should let
Sorry.
You go.
On top of everything, Rosie thinks she's in love with young Patrick. I mean, that's a breaking heart happening if I ever saw one.
I don't believe for a second that Zachary committed suicide. We'd only just run through his plan for the spring seedlings yesterday.
Yes, sure. But he was upset, believing his sister was dead.
I'd say worried about how things would be handled with Gregory and Emma taking over. I said to let him stay here, but Ethel was sure Emma would throw him out first chance she got. And now we'll never know.
Oh, my. You're taking this hard, aren't you?
Hi there.
Must be 100 years old at least.
I'll never get how to rip through this. All this fuss for a pretend funeral. And why not do a photo shoot because we're all gathered? Talk about messed up multitasking. And who's carrying the load?
I'll never again meet someone like Zachary.
Us.
I can't bear to think of what happened to all these rare plants down here, too.
I know, Oliver, I know. But we shall all miss him dearly.
Sir, back off. Understand?
Emma Carlyle in the greenhouse. How curious.
Damn it. I need this to work. Why did it have to break on me now? This is the last thing I need. Junk. I just need some thingy. Christ, I have no idea.
Broken lab equipment. It looks like it was recently used, though.
This is a table showing lethal dosages for the poison used to kill Zachary.
Something is circled, 47. Female, age 65 to 79, 60 to 64 kilograms. I'd say Madame Carlyle is next in line for a poisoning. You have uncovered enough evidence to tell Madame Carlyle that Emma is the murderer. Quite the detective, 47. I'm impressed. I suggest you go tell Mr. Fernsby. Unless you think there are more secrets to uncover.
Now Zachary won't get to see the residential area.
I understand why you're so upset.
Can you please sit down?
Yes.
If I could just think of something interesting to say during the shoot to grab Rebecca's attention. I had one to offer.
So many of the things. We'll get everything we planned for the next few months done in 3 days.
I know we're not supposed to talk about it. What's that whole thing about?
You may laugh now, but I have not that I know anything.
Like that, I bet you've worked with
Ferry,
but
back
I think
to...
I...
Right, yeah.
Hello, sir.
Coming along inside. Is everything ready for tomorrow?
I'm getting a headache from all the decisions. I mean, pram or stroller, comforter.
If you'll follow me, sir.
Should I ask her to marry me? What if she says no? And then this big funeral thing tomorrow. Last thing I need.
Amy is a great lass. You love her, she loves you. And now a wee one.
Hey, how are you?
This is Madame Carlyle's office. Please step inside.
Sup?
I can't forget his eyes. He was so close.
So, Mr. Whitmer, you've reached a conclusion. Take a seat. Please, go ahead.
Your niece, Emma Carlyle, murdered your brother Zachary.
My niece? Emma is not my niece. She's my daughter-in-law.
And your niece. Emma is the illegitimate child of your late older brother, Montgomery, who you and Zachary killed 46 years ago.
That's preposterous.
You asked me to find out what happened to Zachary. Would you rather not know?
No. No, go on.
I found a letter from Emmer's mother, Jane, who was the fiancé of your older brother at the time of his death. She witnessed how you and Zachary pushed him off the balcony. She believed you did it to steal the Carlisle Empire from her and her unborn child. And she raised Emmer to reclaim what she lost, marry your heir, Gregory, get revenge, and secure the Carlisle Empire for her bloodline generations to come.
Emma is the daughter of Montgomery and that local girl, Jane.
She is.
Well, the girl got it wrong. I didn't steal anything. I did what was necessary to protect the future of the Carlisles. Montgomery wasn't cut out to take over from father, all heart and no balls.
Emma used the funeral gathering to speed up her installment as the lady of the house, seizing the opportunity to stage Zachary's suicide. She did her homework, used a poison made from one of Zachary's rare plants, found old floor plans from Thornbridge Manor to gain access to his room through a secret passage.
That scheming bitch.
More than you think. I found proof that she will try to poison you next.
Well, I'll have to take care of that. Thank you, Mr. Whitmer. You have not disappointed. I promised you I would reward you generously if you solved the case. So, what do you suggest?
I want the file you have on Arthur Edwards.
Edwards, the Constant. But how do you... Oh, I see. I expected you might show up. But to kill me, not help me. But I've been wrong on so many things lately, so why not this one? I will give you the file on Edwards. You've earned it. I don't suppose I could convince you to deal with my daughter-in-law now you're here. I would like to see her dead. No? What a shame. I'll have to see to it some other way then. The file you want is in the safe. God, I hope you get Edwards and make him hurt. I need some privacy.
Greetings, sir.
Thank you.
Good work, 47. That's the file on Arthur Edwards secured. Time to take care of Madame Carlisle.
Mission complete. Well done, 47.
Help! Help me, please!
Take this place. Access from graveyard, trophy room, and the office.
Alpha 6 actual. Over. This could be an accident, but I wouldn't rule out foul play.
They're everywhere. Go, get out! It's the Constantine! Shit!